Now today, we'll use grid and card component to work on the blog. First, let's create a new component. So open your code editor, open components, and here, create a new file, blog.js. We'll create a functional component, so add export default function and the component name, app-blog. In return, let's just add a div tag with the text blog. Now, let's import this component under app.js. So on top, import app blog. Then at the bottom, add app blog element. Check the preview. And we can see blog. It means our component is working. Now, let's add this title and a subtitle. We will also use the grid layout. So open React Bootstrap, click Components, Layout, and Grid. We will use Fluid Container. So copy the import of container, row, and col. You can add them in blog.js. Then copy the container element. Here, remove this div tag and instead add the section. Add ID blog and a class block and blog block. Inside this section, you can paste the container element. And for title and subtitle, just after this container, add a div tag with a class title holder. For the title, let's add the s2 tag. Then for the subtitle, let's add another div tag with a class subtitle. You can copy the subtitle from the website and you can paste it over here. Once done, check the side. And now you can see title and subtitle. Now let's add all of this card information under the card component. So go back to React Bootstrap, click components and card. Copy the import of card and add them at the very top. Then copy this card element and here in col element in small device, let's add the grid value of 4. Inside col, let's add a div tag with a class holder. And inside this holder, you can paste your card element. We don't need this inline width, so you can remove them. And instead of this button, I will replace them with the A tag. The text of the button is read more. Let's also add the SREF attribute and add a class btn and btn-primary. For the icon of this button, you can copy from the developer tool of the website and you can paste them after the read more text. We also got date over here, so I will add them under the time tag. So here we will show the date. So these are the static content, but I want to use a dynamic one. So on top, I will add the blog data. Here I've got properties like ID, image, time, title, description, and link. To access this data, we can use a map function. So just after this row, I can write blogdata.map. We can then access blog. Then inside this return, you can add this call element. Now in the call element, add key attribute and add blog.id. To access the image, you can now use blog.image. To access the date, you can use blog.time. For the title, you can use blog.time. For description, let's use blog.description. And finally, for the link, we can use blog.link. Click the site now, and this time you can see the blog is working. If you compare it with the design, it is looking exactly the same. Great! This is the end of the session. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. Thank you.